Hello, welcome. Happy April, everyone. Happy April. We're almost done with it. Last time I talked a little bit about Readwise. I talked a lot about Readwise, actually. A lot, way too much. And one of my favorite things that I've been trying to just really go all out on is the visual customization of my notes, because there's a lot of things that help me just help me. Color coding really helps me, and little icons help me, so emojis and all that. I don't use like emojis throughout the note really. I used to use them for the headers, you know, and I liked how it looked in the outline pane and stuff like that. But I've kind of gone away from that, but I still really like the little icons for the note titles. And you can put emojis in just like in your file names. Most operating systems will support that pretty okay. You will get some issues if you use third-party syncing stuff. But they like the operating system themselves support it in the sense that it's not gonna like crash or delete your file most likely. But it doesn't really like doesn't get displayed on the operating system level usually well. At best, you get a little outline of what it's what the emoji would be, or maybe you get a bunch of boxes, and that just kind of weirds me out. And I just feel like it could lead to some complications, even just doing basic, simple stuff like copying saving a copy of my vault to an external backup drive or something. That could potentially have some issues with it. So I don't like to do that on the file name level. So I use a couple different things. I've been using a little icon, frontmatter, in my notes for data view calls. That's largely been replaced with Supercharged Links, which is a plugin that will let you set up different styling criteria for different types of notes, and you can do this in a number of ways. So I've got a few down here that will say if the note has the tag source slash books, if the note has the tag source slash tweets, source slash podcasts. So these are all the things I was using in the Readwise customization, and you can see there's even the source slash videos, which is taken from the source URL in the Readwise source. And then I also have source slash post. So if I save a forum post or a Reddit post to Readwise, it's going to get that that tag automatically. And so with Supercharged Links, basically you install it through the community plugin tab. And then inside the actual Supercharged Links options, you can create selectors. And so, like, let me open up. Select what links to style. So, type of selector, tag, attribute value, which is a front matter value, or a path. So, the folder or directory that it's in. So, I've got tag and then source slash videos. And then a bunch of options here, little toggle buttons. Just keep them all toggled. There's not a single reason to change those. So if you hover over them, you can see what they'll do. I guess if you use this a lot, you can turn off certain types of styling so that perhaps it might increase decrease like I guess loading time when the plugin's being sorted through or something like that. It gives you a little preview of the result here. So you just say, hey, tag, and then what tag, and that's it. Then in style settings, which is another plugin you'll have to install alongside it, you'll get one that says Supercharged Links, and it'll have basically a mirror of the selectors that you set up in the Supercharged Link. So if I go down here to the source slash video one, it gives me the little example right here. So I have it prepending text, which in this case is an emoji and a space. It's a little VHS cassette. If you don't know what that is, it's okay. You can use a video camera or something. So if you're under 20 or 25, maybe, you can use whatever icon you want there. And then append text, append, prepend, append, append. You can have it append text if you want the icon behind it. And you can do multiple settings. So you can have, you can have multiple links affected by multiple supercharged selectors. So if you use a front matter tag to denote if a note is finished or if you have to work on it or something like that. Well, you can have a selector that will look at that tag and add like a yellow square, red square, green square to it, depending on the status of that note. And that will work even if it applies to other selectors. So if I did that, and I had it so that any like readwise thing automatically came in with the, to-do little YAML indicator, then it would go through and it would have that little marking behind it. So like a red icon or something, right? And then as I go through and I process that note in whatever way I process them, I can just go in there and I can change that. So pretty cool. You can change the font decoration. So whenever you link to specific notes, maybe it's going to be bold or underlined depending on certain things. I never remember what the rules are for, when you write out the name of a book versus the name of an article versus the name of some other type of media. You know, I think you just do quotes on something, some things you italicize, I don't know any of that. But you could go through and you could set that up. So, hey, any of these things that are tagged with books are always going to be stylized like this, etc. You know, you can change the font weight, you can change the color, which I think is super, super cool. And you can even do things like add. So, like, normally you can't have, your file name cannot have a question mark in it, and there's some other characters that you can't have in the actual file name of your note because it messes with the operating system and how it runs. So with supercharged links, you could add question marks or other things like that so that in your Obsidian vault they're going to appear with that question mark, but they won't actually have that in the file name, so nothing goes wonky on the operating system level. So that's really cool. As far as like the title and stuff goes, I think another thing that I use that directly affects that is the community plugin frontmatter title. So this is a plugin that will look at the YAML, the frontmatter in your notes, and you tell it what particular ID in the key you want it to look in that. So I just have a title, and you can say, where do you want that attribute, that value, to be displayed instead of the actual note title? So in the file explorer, in the graph view, the header, the star panel, RIP starred, search results, in tabs, the inline title, canvases, backlinks. So that lets you title a note as far as your Obsidian Vault is concerned, completely independently of how it's titled on the operating system level. That's another way you can add icons. It's also another way that you can use different characters that you wouldn't normally be able to use in a title. And it's very useful. I quite like it a lot because there are times where I'm doing like maybe like technical notes where it's like I'm going through and I'm using a program and I'm learning stuff and I'm trying to like put in to these notes, like, well, what features did I have to do research for to actually kind of really understand them? And let me put, like, my findings there so that I know exactly next time when I need to refresh my memory, I know where to go. And so those titles aren't always very intuitive or very human friendly to read, but I can make them human friendly with this plugin super easily. The last one that I wanted to just go over real quickly, if you're someone that needs or enjoys these color coding type things, and just real quick, jumping back to the supercharged links, I use Obsidian for story writing. And one of the things that I do is, I'll have notes for events and locations and all that stuff. And then I style those separately. And that really helps me. So, you can look at a paragraph of stuff, not like prose, but like the technical behind the scenes details, like the world building, right? And I can look at a paragraph and I can see how many references super quick are there, right? But the color coding and all that. But let's open up one of the supercharged link style things. So you can also change the background color of a note. I think this is a bit too much. I think this is a lot for me. It's a little bit too much. But you can, if you want, change the entire background color of a note based on tags or the YAML properties that it matches. I just found out, like about 15 minutes ago, 20 minutes ago, just going through the recently released community plugins, colorful note borders. So this lets you match a folder or a front matter value. You can't do tags currently, but this is enough for me. It comes with a couple different default ones: category public, category private. Gives you a green border, gives you a red border. I did one for just like to mess around. I did one for my sources, and then one for the folder that a specific project is in. So, for example, this one on the left here, this is a readwise export note. And it's got the little like gray border around it. So no matter where I am in the note, if I'm confused or whatever, or if I've got a whole bunch of stuff open, I can easily, very clearly see what that is. And then over here, this is using the YAML key private. It gives it a little red border. This is a red danger zone border. If I go over to this one, I've got a blue border, which matches the value I put in the one that's looking at just the directory that it's in. So I got a little blue border there. And then just a little example, you can see if I type in and link to a note that's a readwise note, it gets the little newspaper icon. Right, so you can see how that the styling and stuff affects all of that. So just a little quick trip today down to the customization store, getting some color coding. It's something that I really am trying to prioritize in my Obsidian Vault, and I'm trying to make it kind of propagate outwards. So I'm looking at the different things that I use, or which can be, my email clients with automatic filtering and stuff that's done in there. Readwise and all of that stuff. It could be, my file system on my hard drive. It could be whatever, any place that I can use these same colors, same icons and stuff across things to make it so that when I'm moving back and forth between different things, it's as easy for me as possible. That's it. So, we got colorful note borders. We got front matter title. and we got supercharged links. All things that I think everyone should play around with a little bit, especially if you are really into emojis and using those as indicators and cues for you to keep you on track or to help you navigate around your mess that is your Obsidian Vault or your, or your Google Drive or your everywhere. You know, you can do a lot of color coding in a lot of apps nowadays, and I'm working on figuring out the calendar situation and tasks and where do I actually want those to be kept, and it's a lot of work. You all know this. It's a lot of work. It's fun, but a lot of work. And I think that as far as Obsidian goes, these are three plugins that you probably can't use, can't go without. I think they're fantastic. So all right, there we go. Happy April.